This is the 11th Guru Talk we are having.
11th?
Yeah. And it's a pleasure to have you all here, and especially the icon who doesn't need much of an introduction, Mr. Chandramohan. A towering personality was achieved there, and he's inspired many. And very highly, you know, high energy driven gentleman. And I would not take much time. I'll rather request Mr. J.P. Singh, our charter member, a very active charter member of Thai, to come and introduce Chandramohan ji, and then we'll take on his story. And after that, we'll engage more of a Q&A interaction, because Guru Talk is all about mentoring.
Ideas are always available in abundance. You must
get it about available.
Ladies are not available. The ideas are always available in abundance. It's the ideas which get converted to implementation stage, and the success stories are the ideas which matter. And we have an icon here who converted an idea to a level which probably we cannot even think of. And these are the people who make and mark the organization. They are the true leaders. So we have one such leader among us. He is a rare blend of, I would say a rare blend of an engineer scientist, an innovator, an educationist, a visionary entrepreneur, and a top class leader. He invented a product in way back in, I would say, 75-80s, which is known as a Swat tractor. So totally with indigenous technology. And then he started the first major large-scale venture and converted into a 1500 crores conglomerate, which is known as a Swaraj Group of Industries. He blended a techno-entrepreneurship in auto and solar units around Swat tractors. Whatever development we see in Mohali, Rupert today is mainly to one gentleman who is sitting over here. He has a book called Zero to Blue Chip, which was published in 2001. And that book is a true lesson in management in so-called Indian environment. Correct, sir? He has his experience hands down all the time. His management is hands-on, which led to a national level, I would say, intervention, and all the organizations like FICCI, PhD, CII started focusing on entrepreneurship development after he gave the focus to them, after the entrepreneurship. He has been on board of directors to IIT Delhi in the 80s. He has been chairman of AICT North. He has been president of ARAI Pune in the 90s. He retired in 1997 and he is still pursuing his passions. What are his passions? Total quality management, technical education, and to bridge the gap between an engineering college lab and the industry. He has been on board of the directors of a number of organizations. For example, he has been currently he is chairman of board of directors at PC, we call it PET. He is chairman governing council of PTU Gyan Jyoti Institute of Technology in Mohali. He is board of director on board of Punjab Technical University Jalandhar, GDS Indraprastha University Delhi, and Shri Ram Institute of Industrial Research in Delhi. He has lot of citations and international awards which I would like to mention. Few of them are FICCI Award for Research and Technology in 1974, way back, I was only 8 years old at that time. National Gold Shield for Import Substitution, Salwater Pucky Prize for Outstanding Contribution to Production Engineering in Subcontinent, Association Award for Production of Incendiaries, 1979 I am Toshiba Marketing Man of the Year Gold Shield Award, 1985 Padma Shri, he got 1999 IMC Juran Medical for Lifelong Dedication to Quality. Again, there is no lady. Gentlemen, please join me in inviting Padam Shri Chandramohan ji on the dais to share his experiences. He is an aspiring personality who faced and overcame many challenges during his journey so far. And I hope he continues as long as possible. He is an icon and he is here to share his experiences and share his knowledge with us. Please welcome.
Social, very, very friendly, fancy interest in games. And always in for fun, always enjoying fun. Of course, couldn't study, parent part of that. So, and my dad, my aunt taught me the finer art aspects of life, art, paint, this, that, you know. But father taught me tinkering with things. I learned model drawing when I was class 10, shorthand and typing when I finished school, college, I was first year college, watch repairing, locomotive repairing, all sorts of things. Every summer vacation I had to do something. Plus a lot of reading. I'm just telling you because there are certain things which to me are very important, have become like very large interest in that, and helped me shape my mental mind to do that exercise. Learning to tinker with various things. My dad was, he was a lawyer, surveyor of India, and then turned into a lawyer. I was the only genetic non-lawyer, although it's a legal profession, the whole family, grandfather, long. But then went into engineering. I was the only character who by choice went in for mechanical engineering. That day, those days, 1950, I did my BA and then went into engineering. Those time admission was on merit, you know, straight BA from engineering, PC in Roorkee, that was that kind of thing. And the civil engineering was the outstanding, 100% preference. Anybody had a choice? Mechanical engineering went for the absolute, you know, for the day. So I, last first 5-7 years, I was when I answering this question, why are you, I said, that the Maharaja. Why the hell you could have opted for civil? I said, I didn't feel like, no, what are you craving about? Period. So civil engineering jobs are guaranteed. First 10, Indian Civil Service, Indian Service of Engineers. Next, class 1, PhD, class 1, number 2, yeah, all that stuff. Anyway, finally, joined the railways, Tinker Brown, joined the railways, I'm in the railways for 10, 12 years. Last 5, the railway research. But always, the mind was always too efficiency driven, productivity driven, industrial engineering and innovation. Try to do something which cuts down effort. This was my basic mind. And there, then I moved on to CSR, Senior Laboratory in the research department. There we got into the first mechanical laboratory, very fresh, very new. And there, wanted to do something big. No idea what to help to do. Well, the research had given me a lot of depth into various. I could investigate, I learned electronics, I do all sorts of things. And there, I got an opportunity to develop a mokai for St. Raleigh, the cycle manufacturer. They died cycle manufacturers in 1965. But they were the largest cycle manufacturer in 1965 in the country, by far. And Raleigh was well known. So, designed, including an engine, designing a moped, including an engine, cycle, mounted engine, plus cycle, moped for them. A scooter for escorts. They were making escorts riding motorcycles at the time. And to convert that into a scooter. And thirdly, on our own, a project in the national, design a tractor. A totally 20 horsepower tractor, because Government of India was very keen to put up a 20 horsepower tractor. Those days there were five companies making tractors. Escorts, International Tractors, Tapping Madras, that kind of sport, because Massey Ferguson Madras, one more, four or five. And the Government of India had come, and somebody making a Russian tractor, DT 14 horsepower tractor, which other Russian tractor was 8,000 rupees and the others were 13-14,000. So, but it was the Russian pricing, but no, it was, since we were dirt cheap, we must make a 20 horsepower tractor. That was the national decision, Kaplan Commission. That's how we got into it, and we said we do it in India. And I got it. Gradually, we made the first moped. I drove the first moped out. Our own engine made by us. It was a 37cc engine, I remember. And St. Raleigh's managing director from the UK had also come to see the engine being on a dynamometer. So, but then where same rally when it broke, they went broke, that thing had to be shared out as such. Yeah. Escorts, we made the first scooters. We had a run, three scooters in the run from Delhi to Calcutta. Simultaneously, two Vespas. That time Bajaj was called, Chetak was called the Vespa, still you remember. One Liberta scooter. हमने लिबर्टा का क्या नाम नहीं सुना
सुना
नाम डेट वो एंड एक ना हमारा पुटअप सो लिबर्टा यूज टू स्पार्क का यूज टू फॉल एवरी 200 किलोमीटर्स ऑन दिस लैंड फाइव मोटरसाइकिल कमिंग स्ट्रेट एंड फर्स्ट स्टॉप दुर्गापुर आर हाउस फर्स्ट स्टॉप सो दिस थिंग वाज वेस्पा वेंट लाइक अ क्लीन शॉट नो क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड Rajdoot, we had for doing, was also okay. No. That is when we learned that basic problem with the Liberta was spark plug heating. So then we started, and then we investigated the whole other, you know, whole engine profile, airflow profile. But to cool the spark plug, especially Vespa had a Vespa engine, had a jet at 40 meters a second, flowing directly on. That's how they designed the product. Any case, we did all this. We made the first batch of, I think, 15 scooters. And it was called the Jawan. That time, Lal Bahadur Shastri, you know, we had won that war. Lal Bahadur, so it was named the Jawan. And the first time, I think, taken the whole batch, 15 scooters, went on session to the Prime Minister's house. But Escorts lost influence over the whole thing. Fizzled out. Tractor kept on, gradually the interest kept on getting deeper and deeper and deeper. And the fight, you know, we had a national fight again. There were lots of people against this whole thing. HMT, that we're going for collaboration, this is waste of time, and all that interest. Keep it. And, but in this design, the core team was five people. Of course, the whole institute was involved, prototyping. It's a massive exercise. Because all the other people were basically importing the things, only assembling them. This I'm talking of 65, 67. And here, then we said we will make everything Indian, no question about it. And imports, no question. So it meant a lot of tooling being done, this being done, that being done. So delays, so put money. Money was not there. Any case. So one side was a political fight, one side was the technical fight. So both had to go parallel. And finally HMT came into the picture. HMT was running into losses in 1969, very large losses, depression, this thing. So they decided that they'll import these. See, make tractors. From machine to that time, HMT was only making machine tools across the country. They had a plant up here in Punjab, still there. So then they said that they will take a manufacturer of tractors here in Punjab with Czech collaboration. And we went on to head-on fight. And it went on to the cabinet. And in the cabinet committee, remember the last meeting in the Parliament House, the cabinet secretary to me, the Rashtrapati Bhavan. So we all land up. I was myself. There were four. It was a huge round table. Some 30, 40 people. Secretary of the Government of India. Big bosses. I was a young kid at that time. In 1970, I was what? 37. 32 born. So long meeting. The same. I was all against. I'm the only person defending. Finally. After 1 hour meeting, the cabinet secretary said, thank you so much, gentlemen. The decision taken in favor of HMT, everyone did it. Because we came up to the lift, hey, dekha, but apne aapko samajh kar ladai kar paya. I said, somehow, somewhere, I'll make this track. That is when this whole PTO thought came on. So when we came in here, 1970, the team moved in here in May. The whole government was rich. Everyone telling them, are you mad? Nationally rejected. Why don't you opt for four? Why don't you opt for this? By then, another 10, 12 people had come in. So finally, the Punjab government said, okay, we'll accept it. why did you raise the money? And that came with 3 crore 70 lakhs. Lot of money. And then only we raise the money. When you raise that money, we put in an equity maximum 45 lakhs. This is the maximum. Bucky, you have to do whatever that is. So that is what it took me 2 years to raise the finally, lot of, not only buggered around, actually buggered around nationally, and finally the job was done. And PGL in first produced the first tractor in 19. First 13 tractors were rolled up from 13th of April 1974. The name was of course declared by, Swaraj name was given by Mrs. Gandhi. He cleared the army when he was still in the president. Also my girlfriend's name. But anyway, that's how it is. We went on. And first few years were really tough. I think the one thing which I think all of you must understand, the production is still easy. The toughest game for anything is finding a customer. Not only a customer, but somebody who also pays you. I mean, without that, life is. So this is where I thought is the most critical part and become tougher still. Finding a customer. How to find a customer? So this is where we spent a lot of time in the beginning. Now I'll elaborate that. That's why I will send you that photograph.
That's already there.
Okay, show you that. First thing was that the tractor, our product must look unique. So that even if, I mean, if everyone is wearing a dark suit, then I can't distinguish who it is. Can happen. Can I? No. So we said we must make a unique color scheme. Period. So all the tractors that time were red or shades of red, monocolor. So I was the first tractor to make a two-tone tractor. Then we had no money for tooling. We made a tooling in such a fashion, which was the common one, that how to make it without tooling, a good-looking thing without money. You have to attract the customer to your showroom. But they are coming. So then came in. Can you bring it back to the first one?
Yeah.
From the farthest distance. Jitni dusre dekho ki the tavi aayega na. We found here both times that the most visible signboard in the whole town was SO. ESSO was the Standard Oil board. And it was on a white background, red letters, oval. Placed across the road, not parallel to the road, but across the road. So he said, yeah, here. That is how this, you see that top logo came out. He put it across the road, high, so nobody can know it. So that made it visible from a kilometer. In any busy area, you don't see it from a kilometer. So, okay. Then you come nearer, then the logo itself was done, the lettering style. Swaraj was done in a fashion that, you know, really. But then later, after some years, so it was later, when we got into Mazda, here if you look at it, the Swaraj is, it's written in italics, and the normal lowercase, not the I. Mazda had done a different exercise, that they, if I style, you see now one, can you move on to the next slide or do I do that?
Upper.
And no, maybe. Yeah.
Upper, upper, niche.
Niche, yeah. Niche. The logo was changed. Same thing, J was stylized.
Right.
J was stylized. You can see that now?
Right.
By stylizing, I made the letters much bolder. But normally in any writing, height is always restricted. Width is normally free. I mean, you anywhere. Now you just see it. The Swaraj in the same height, they've written. It looks too weak. Visibility is much poorer. So I'm just trying to say that this is what it is like. And then comes in next one. You will have to do that, Sumit. So you got whatever opportunity you get, you flog it. I never, if you read Steve Jobs' different book. When the first Apple they launched up in that Comdex or whatever they had, for very first show, they put in some stall somewhere, nobody came to have a look at it. That's when they got this Professor Marakula as the chairman from Stanford. And he's the one who said to look, make up. This you must make a presentation, the first presentation to public must be large. Must be unique, not large but unique. Make it such that people come. So next one they did it. They did it, they put it in the front of the stall, front of the Comdex, curtains, roofs, I mean, stalls, all Nakhran they did. And their stall was full and that got what got Apple going. And if you take thereafter that lesson all his life, Steve Jobs was the classicest, whether he launched iTunes, everywhere, I mean name it, and this is the most classic launch of any new product. And he rehearsed on it thoroughly, again and again and again, how to flog it maximum. I thought let me, do a scan. Similarly, and this I have seen it, I tell everyone, and wherever possible, flog the opportunity which you get. Free, for free publicity. Because